Hi, over the next few videos, we're creating a trivia question microservice from scratch, end to end. That means all the code, all the infrastructure to build, test, deploy, and run. To start, this video is a roadmap for the microservice we're going to create. It will give you an idea for all the technologies we're going to use to create our microservice. This tutorial demonstrates a way to create a microservice. This isn't the way. There are many solutions to this problem, but hopefully, this will give you enough direction to start creating your own microservices. The videos also diverge from how other tutorials work on DGU.com. Every video in this playlist builds on the previous video. We're building something much bigger and we can't do it all in one video. So let's get started. Imagine we're creating an online trivia game. The game will likely need to handle many tasks. We'll need code to handle our users, code to get new questions, code to handle processing answers, and probably several other functions not listed here. Each function could map to its own microservice. To start, we'll focus on the trivia question service. What we learn from the trivia question service, we can apply to other services as we create them later on. Our trivia questions microservice will handle the trivia questions for our game. Let's list out some of the use cases we'll need for our microservice. The use cases matter because they describe the API we need to create. For starters, we'll need to get a question. This could be a particular question, or maybe we'll need a random question. We'll do both. We could expand this to get the questions from a category or other more complex use cases, but we'll keep things simple for now. We'll want to be able to get the list of questions. This will simply return a list of questions available. We might have a million questions, so we won't want to return all the questions at once. We'll page the number of questions and keep it at a reasonable amount. Our microservice API will also need to tell the user how to navigate forward and backward in the list of questions. So we'll need to know how many questions there are. We're going to put all of this inside a continuous integration process. If we're constantly building and deploying our applications, we can easily lose track of which version is running in production. This means our microservice needs to be able to tell us which version is running. We'll add a call that returns the version information for the microservice. These calls make up the API for our microservice. Since I just mentioned continuous integration, let's talk about how that's going to look when we set it up. Our continuous integration system will look like this. We'll use a Git repository to manage our version control. In Git, we'll add a trigger for when we issue a pull request to notify a build server to build our code. This will build our microservice, we'll run our tests, package it up, and then store it in an artifact manager. We're storing every build in an artifact manager so we can roll back to the previous version just in case we deploy something bad. And then finally, we'll deploy our microservice to production.
This all happens automatically, so that's why it's important we include testing and version information in our microservice. We need to know what is running and what code was used to create it.
You can use almost any programming language to create microservice, but we're going to use Java for these tutorials. All of the concepts still apply for any language you use. We'll use Maven to describe how to build our microservice. If you're unfamiliar with Maven, you might want to check out the Maven playlist. It's listed below. Our trivia microservice will expose a REST API that returns trivia questions in a JSON format. Almost every language knows how to make HTTP calls and process JSON text. We're going to implement our microservice using Wildfly Swarm. That's a framework for creating Java microservices that can run independent of a Java EE container. Technically, we're putting the Java EE container inside our application. If you're uncertain what a Java EE container is, that's all right. The short story is, in the past we ran web applications inside a container like Wildfly or WebSphere. That makes our microservices unnecessarily complicated and we end up deploying much more than just our application. Wildfly Swarm hides all these things inside a single jar. At the end of the day, our application is just a jar, but we still get most of the benefits of running in a Java EE container. There's a bit more to it, but that's all we really need to know for now. Our microservice will be created in a Docker container. This will ensure that what runs in our development machine matches what's deployed in production. It will also make it very easy to provision more instances of our microservice as needed. We'll cover preparing our application to run in a container and building the application into a container. Finally, we need to deploy our Docker container to run somewhere. We're going to run it on AWS, but you can configure your build to deploy wherever you run your Docker containers.
So hopefully this gives you a taste for everything we're going to cover. It's pretty exciting. We'll cover each topic in depth as we build our service. If you have any questions, let me know. For some of the bigger questions, I'll add them to the end of these tutorials. You can find the code on GitHub and the complete transcripts on dg.com. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.